a bicycle racer. But I gave the albums with all the pictures to his grandson. There's a John C. Garrels Jr. I have pictures of him, a picture. And there's a John C. Garrels III, who lives in Connecticut. And there is a John C. Garrels IV, who lives in central Massachusetts and is a school principal for the state of Massachusetts prison system. John C. the Fourth. But our Olympic hero grew up in Bay City. He went to school at the University of Michigan, and while there, he earned 4 letters in track and 2 letters in football. He was on the football team all 4 years, but Fielding Yost, the coach, did not allow freshmen to play, and he was on the team his junior year, but I don't know if he got in any games or not. But in the fall of 1905, which was a very famous year for Michigan football, that year they scored 495 points. They were known as the original point-a-minute team, and they only had 2 points scored against them, and they lost that game 2-0. And that was, I think, over in Chicago against the University of Chicago, who had a football team in those days. They don't play football anymore. The other interesting thing about that particular game, Yost took 13 players with him. One of the 11 active players got knocked cold. So one of the 2 substitutes did get in the game. The other guy never even got in the game. But they lost that game 2-0. That was fall of 1905. There was one first-string All-American that year. His name was Adolph Schultz. He was Michigan's second All-American. The first one was Willie Heston in 1902. That's the same Heston family that owns the big cemetery down in Flat Rock Way. John Garrels did make a second string All-American. He didn't make first string All-American in the fall of 06. And he got a degree from Michigan Chemical Engineering and spent most of his life working for the old Wyandotte Chemicals as director of plant research.
How did he come to be an Olympian for the Olympic Games 1908?
He was sponsored by the Chicago Track Club, and I have no idea why. But as I say, he was quite a track star at Michigan, and that's where his reputation was built and why he was selected to be on the Olympic team that year.
And how many medals did he win, and in what?
He won a silver medal in hurdles and a bronze medal in shot put.
So that's 2 different disciplines.
Which, it wouldn't happen today. Either you run or you do field events. Today they don't do both. He was disappointed with his silver because in the tryouts to make the team, he beat the guy every time, but he got a bad start at the Olympics, and in a short run like hurdles, it makes all the difference. The start is everything. But I'm pretty sure that picture of him as a bicycle racer as a kid is in the group, the collection that I sent to his grandson, John the Third. That was taken in Ann Arbor. There is a select group of Michigan letter winners known as Michigama, and that was a reunion out at, was taken at Fred Matthai's farm.
This one? This one here?
That one, yeah. Let me take a look at that badge. It might tell us what year he's up there. Oh, I think it says 07. That's when he graduated. Yeah, 07. The other thing that always tickled me was the people that were elected to Michigama. You had to be a good student as well as a big-time athlete. They gave him all names. His name was Mighty Oak. Six-three in those days, just after the turn of the century, was a big, big man. Today the girls are 6'3", and the guys get bigger and bigger. I mean, there's any number of kids that play football for Michigan that are like 6'7", and 300 pounds.